Hey everyone, it's Maggie Bot here to do another No Blomo blog. And today we are going to continue my top 10. So the number 9 came in with a game that I've played a heck of a lot of. It's a very good game. It's a worker placement game called, no surprise, Kalis. Kalis is a 2-5 player game, lasts about an hour, hour and a half. You are some blotty blahs trying to build a castle, get favors from a king. Very original. But this is a worker placement game in which the players then are affected by this kind of movement piece, the bailiff and the provost. And in the game, you have to pay money to take an action, or at least propose an action. So I place my piece down, I pay a money. Place your piece down, you pay a money. And as people pass, those actions get more expensive. And then, after everyone's passed around, you've paid all your money to try and bid on actions. Almost all actions, players can pay money to have actions not resolved. So there's a little provost that moves around the snaking board, and you pay money to move it backwards. And whatever is after that piece does not resolve that round. It's an interesting interaction that you don't see often in minigames because it's really confrontational. There's not a lot of fighting in games that use the kind of castle building mechanics. This is not just rivalrous actions. This is also literally paying money in the game to screw someone over. And so you have to be very careful that player A doesn't convince you to screw over player C when player A was winning, but you do want to screw the leader out of some actions. And the other interesting bit of this game, very specifically for me, is that you start with some like beginner buildings, and as you progress in the game, you build more buildings, and eventually you can take over the economy of a specific resource. So there's wood, food, stone, cloth, and gold. And I can be the player that controls all the buildings that make cloth. And every time you go to a cloth building, you pay me in either points or resources. And I really like that kind of forced economy on a game, because in order to build in the castle, you need kind of a wealth of unique goods. And in order to get those and get favors, you have to go to lots of different things, and you have to get your actions to resolve, so you have to deal with other people. And it's just good fun, and you can't get too far behind without just losing the whole thing. But it's kind of forgiving for about a round or so. I don't know. It's just overall is a really neat game. And that same provost that makes it where actions don't resolve is also a way to speed up or slow down the game. So if it ends up going farther than it should that round, then it will actually speed up the game by a turn. And if it's pushed back and actions aren't resolving the turn, the game slows down a little bit. So very interesting, very interactive. I've played Kalis probably 20, 30 times in my life. And William Adia, the designer, he made that and the card game for Kalis Magna Carta. And then he just kind of fell off the face of the earth for like 7 years, maybe longer. Last year he came out with a game called Spirium. And Spirium is really good, too. It's a very unique little worker placement. I'm not going to call it a top 10 at this point because I think there's only so many paths to victory in that one. Because it's card-based, there are some cards that are better than others, so you have to just kind of go for the two or three engines that work. But that's another game that's just interesting and in-depth and goes up to 5 players and works really well and plays under an hour. So very unique. If you don't have Spirium, you should definitely pick it up, especially if you like Kalis. But I guess that's all for now. Thanks for following along with my vlog today. It's been a lot of fun. I have a ton of stuff to talk to you guys about, so I'm not really having trouble thinking of what to say. But if you do want to hear anything or any stories or you have any questions about gaming or my gaming life, by all means, bring them up. I'll see you guys later. Bye.